Hello, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are all doing great. Today I have a reveal slash review video for you guys. But before we get started on that, I did want to say a few things. It has been forever since I last filmed or uploaded a video. I believe it has been, my last video was sometime in January, but officially my last film video was in November, Thanksgiving week. And it has been such a roller coaster ride, to be honest with you. Since then, I have had two surgeries and full-on recoveries, but I did keep up with everybody that reached out to me. Thank you guys so much for keeping up with me, making sure that I'm okay, sending me beautiful comments and messages, DMs. It has been nothing but amazing, all the support that I got from you guys. Not only was it a hard, tough recovery physically, but also mentally and emotionally. It was very difficult. So I want to really thank you guys so much from the bottom of my heart for all your kind, well wishes. And even though we are going through this pandemic, where who would have known that 2020 would be such a rough year for everybody? I just hope that all of you guys are staying sane, and I know that obviously there are more important things than luxury, but I feel like it's a really nice escape, and I am so happy to say that personally I am pretty much done recovering for the time being, and I would like to start uploading again with review videos and comparisons, unboxings, tag videos, just because I feel like I had such a rough recovery, and even through the pandemic and all of that, I felt like watching videos on YouTube, it really helped me kind of escape and take a break for at least a little bit. Obviously, being physically healthy is important, but I feel like being mentally and emotionally healthy as well is important. So I hope you guys enjoy this video and catch a little bit of a break, and let's get started. So as soon as I got this item back in March, I revealed on my Instagram. So if you're following me there, I'm sure you know what I picked up. But I also did a live stream a few days ago in Kat Eld's channel in her live stream with Amy. So if you guys haven't checked that video out, I will link it down below. But it was so much fun, and I am so thankful that Kat and Amy reached out and invited me over to join their live stream as their guest. So check out that video if you guys haven't watched it. Again, like I said, I'll link it down below. This is one of the pieces that I did reveal or unboxed in that live stream, along with one more item, which I won't be showing in today's video. You guys can see I have the bag right there still, the box, and pretty much everything that I unboxed in the live stream. I just kind of left it open because I figured I was going to film this video anyway. But let me reveal my bag that I purchased again around the end of March. I've actually worn this piece or used it like crazy, and I feel like I'm able to give you guys my honest review, my thoughts, my pros and cons, prices, measurements, all of that. And to reveal this little beauty right here, this is the Vanity PM from Louis Vuitton. And it is in the reverse monogram. Ever since I've got this piece, I have been dying to want to film a review on this because it was highly requested. So I figured this was going to be my first video back as to review this bag because I absolutely love it. So let me share with you guys all the little things. So I have this little booklet that came with the bag. It's pretty much just care instructions, yada yada. And then I have my receipt, which I will be sharing prices with you. A little dust bag where housed the chain. This chain right here, as you guys can see. And then, like always, I got myself perfume samples, which my SA kindly hooked me up with. And then little dust bags, which one housed the perfume samples and the other one housed the little lock that comes attached to the bag, or I attached it to the bag. So let's get started with kind of the details on this bag. So it is a nice top handle, and it doesn't move back and forth or anything like that. It's pretty stationary. It comes with this little clochette that has the hardware LV on there, which I think it's very different, and it kind of dresses it up a little bit. It's not like the other clochettes that are just plain. In there, obviously, I have the little keys. The lock is really pretty, actually. I don't know if I can get a close-up on there, but it's not like the locks that you get on your Speedies where they tarnish. I found these to be a lot more durable, and it has a little LV stamp right there with a little circle around it, and in the back it just says Louis Vuitton Paris. But these locks, they do not tarnish at all in comparison to, like I said, the Speedy ones that do tarnish, sadly. It has the reverse monogram in the top, then it has the regular monogram and then reverse at the bottom. It comes with four little feet, which I find so super necessary. And then it also has a black leather trimming going all around. So there is absolutely no vachetta, which honestly, it just makes this bag so carefree. I love the chain detail on this, which comes intertwined with leather, and it's also that black leather. I find this chain so special and different, and something that you don't really see too often. And some people love it, some people hate it. I was in the beginning, I wasn't like crazy about it, but I think it grew on me, and now I absolutely love it. You also on the side have a little LV thing right here with the hook where you're able to hook your strap, and obviously that's on both sides. And when you open it up, I currently have an organizer in there, but let me get that out. And that's what the inside looks like. Mine says Louis Vuitton, made in Italy. It is in this black microfiber lining, which I absolutely love. And I have the two tags here. M45165 is the item number for any of you that are interested. So that pretty much wraps up the details on this bag. Now let's get into measurements. I'm going to actually measure this in centimeters just because I feel like it's more accurate that way. So let's do the height of the bag, 12.5 centimeters. Going across this way, you're looking at 18 centimeters, and depth wise you are looking at 10 centimeters in depth. And this little top handle, just for anyone that's interested, you are looking at approximately 6.5 for the little space right there. For the strap drop, I'm going to measure the strap drop just as is, just because there is depth, or there is that length right there. So you are looking at 46.5 centimeters. I'm going to add some mod shots while I talk about the strap drop and all of that. But when it comes down to the top handle, it is big enough where I'm able to easily put my hand through it. It is not big enough for me to use it as a crook of the arm comfortably, but I am able to kind of get away with kind of carrying it like this temporarily when I need to. Obviously, I use the top handle as is. I'm 5'2", by the way, so I'm able to comfortably use this on the shoulder, and I'm also able to get away with using it crossbody as well. I don't think it hits too high up, but honestly, I do prefer my bag sitting a little higher up when I use them crossbody, so I feel like this is perfect. This is not adjustable, obviously, because it is all one chain. I can see why people might feel like that's a pro or a con, because we all have different heights and all that. But honestly speaking, I have been using this bag mostly on my shoulder, just because I did feel like it did dig in a little bit when I wore it crossbody. I much prefer using this bag as a shoulder bag, and I think it just looks so much nicer that way. But it is nice to know that I'm able to wear this crossbody if I needed to, or if I had to for whatever reason. Pros and cons about this bag is, number one, when you hold it like this, you will see that it kind of tilts forward. This is only because it is empty right now. Once my items are filled in, I feel like I don't really have this issue. You guys watched the live stream again. I did show this bag and I was kind of playing around with it, and someone did comment about how flimsy it kind of looks. And it is actually pretty flimsy, as you guys can see. The canvas is very, very soft. It does make the bag a little more difficult to open and close just because of how soft the canvas is. My solution for that, which might be a con or a pro depending on how you look at it, is to have a bag organizer. So I got this bag organizer from Zumoni. I still have a valid discount code for Zumoni if you guys are interested. I believe it's until December. I'll link it down below as always. But I did get this organizer from them and I absolutely love it. I decided to be plain Jane and I just got it in black. I love how this has this optional removable section right here that you could always put in and out if you wanted to. I typically just use it like this, but I love to have this option right here. And it also comes with this little case, which I really like to stand up my little perfume samples. It just makes it a lot more convenient and I make sure that it's not going to be flying around my purse and accidentally get sprayed. So putting this in here just makes it so much easier. If you are contemplating on getting this bag, or if you already have this bag, I highly recommend you get an organizer for it, just because it makes a world of difference when getting in and out of the bag. On top of that, it does help with the structure because it keeps it kind of firm. And as you guys can see, the side, it does have a little bit of an outward dent going on. And this is how I got it. But I feel like if I don't have this organizer or an organizer, I feel like this might get worse over time. As you guys can see, it doesn't look as flimsy and it has a little bit more of a structure. Another con about this bag is the zipper closure and opening. You could already see how much of a struggle it is to get in and out. I feel like some, depending on the bag, the zipper is a little smoother than others. Mine, I feel like it's a little more stiffer, but I don't want to go through putting wax paper over it, and my essay didn't recommend that either. I'm still able to live with it, but I feel like opening it is not really a big deal. When you go like this, you're able to open it. The problem is the closing that kind of takes some time, because as you guys can see, I have to kind of play with it and try to get the top section at the bottom section to kind of match up, and therefore it will close. So most definitely you need two arms to be able to close this. Another bad thing or con about this bag is that I'm not able to easily open and close this bag when I have it on my shoulder or crossbody or whatever. I would have to kind of lift the bag up off my body and try to open it, because what happens is that you open, let's say you are hanging or wearing your crossbody, you try to open the bag and then this kind of gets on the way. If you guys know what I mean. So I have to kind of lift it up, kind of get the chain out of the way in order to be able to open it all the way through. Another question that I got a lot is, am I able to kind of slightly open it halfway and be able to get my things in and out of? Obviously you can, but you will be kind of folding the top canvas right here, and that's probably something that I don't want to do. So I always have to open it all the way up to be able to get in and out of the bag. This little thing, as cute as it is, it also gets in the way when I'm opening and closing this bag. So there's a lot of different steps for this bag. You have to make sure that you're not wearing the bag or the chain is not on the way. Then you have to move this little thing out of the way. You're able to just use one zipper instead of using both. So you can just do this and just open and close with just one zipper back and forth. But honestly, I don't really like doing that. I always like to keep my bag or the zipper in the center, just because it is just aesthetically pleasing. I think it looks so much better and it looks complete. And I feel like when I have both zippers on one side, it just doesn't, it doesn't blow my boat. It doesn't look that pretty. So because of that, I always like keeping this in the center. It feels like I'm talking about a lot of cons, huh? So a lot of people were maybe worried about this little top handle having to pull on the canvas. I don't think it pulls too much. Once again, it might be because I have the the bag organizer in there or whatnot. I am going to fill it up in a little bit and kind of show you guys to see how much it pulls with my stuff in it. This bag is so small that you could only fill it up so much, if you know what I mean. So necessarily, I don't think there's going to be a lot of pulling. So let me fill up the bag according to how much I usually fill it up. Another thing that I did want to mention with this bag is that, as you guys have seen, I have a hard time getting in and out of this bag. So I don't take this bag to places where I know I'm going to need a lot of the things that are inside my bag. So usually when I wear this bag, I found myself just throwing my cell phone down and putting it in my back pocket in my jeans, just because it's just so much more convenient that way. I don't really need to get in and get my car keys in and out of the bag because I have keyless entry and keyless start, so that's really convenient for me. But I did want to mention that, and so let's get my things in here so you guys get an idea on how I pack it. There is the bag, and I have my mini pochette, which I absolutely love. And here I have, obviously, I have hand sanitizer, which is a must these days. And then I have hand lotion because a hand sanitizer gets your hands all dry. I have eye drops. I have my lipstick, which honestly, lipstick with the masks and all that, I don't really know if you need it, but it's nice to always have lipstick just in case. So the mini pochette fits in very nicely just in there. And also keep in mind that I have the organizer, which also takes a little bit of that space, but again, I just feel like it's so necessary. I have my card holder from Louis Vuitton, which a bunch of my cards, and I can just put that in standing up because it has a little bit of a depth on top. Then I have my clay, which houses my car keys. I have them right here, so I can throw that in there as well. And I can have that standing up. And then I have my little Bastia, which I have coins and cash. I absolutely love this piece. You see right there. And then my cell phone, I have the Max, iPhone Max, and I'm able to still put it in there. But again, like I said, I don't usually keep it in my bag, but I wanted to show you guys that it still fits in there. So let's close this up. Again, you need two hands to close it up. And you can see up here, it doesn't really look like it has too much pulling. Obviously, you can see the canvas lifting a little bit, but it's not too bad. If you are going to use a top handle a lot, maybe it might eventually over time. But like I said, I typically use this bag on my shoulder or crossbody, and I only use this top handle part when I'm trying to get in and out of the car and just for easy access. So as you guys can see, it doesn't really lean forward now that it's filled with things. And so that's what I'm saying. When it's empty, it will kind of lean forward. It's probably because the lock is in the front and you have this little clochette leaning in the front, so maybe because of the weight. But once you have like an even amount of weight in the bag, I don't really have that issue with the bag kind of flipping forward. Overall, I think those are all my pros and cons and review about this bag. Will I purchase this again? I feel like, well, obviously I am a bit biased because I already have it. Do I regret buying this bag after knowing and learning about all the cons? Absolutely not. I think that the Cannes bag by Louis Vuitton is kind of like the Nice Bibi, where you do need two hands to be able to get in and out of the bag. It is very fussy to get in and out of the bag. It has a lot of cons, which I already mentioned. And you have to really think whether all those things are going to be worth it for you. So as for me, I absolutely fell in love with this bag as soon as I saw it as a pre-launch picture on Instagram. I absolutely fell in love with it. And even though it does look a lot like the Nice Bibi, I love the fact that this is an actual handbag and it's not like a cosmetic case. So it's just, you just have to ask yourself whether this is a bag that you absolutely love the look of it. For me, it is worth it, even though It has all these cons. Every time I look at it, I absolutely love it because it is just so stinking cute. It's so different. It's something that you don't really see too often. And I know that these were really hard to get as soon as they came out, but I recently found out through the live stream that they're actually available online to purchase. So if you guys are interested, there you go. Let's get into the receipt and the prices. So here is my receipt. Before this launched and you were able to pre-order, this bag was going for $2,340 plus tax here in the US. When I decided that I wanted it and when my SA was able to source it for me, she actually found it the day that there was a price increase. So I ended up paying $2,410 plus tax, which was, I mean, what can you do, right? It's just, that was just my luck. And then there was another increase, like a few months ago, LV had another increase. And so now it's going for $2,540. Is it worth that price tag? When I purchased it for the 2410, I felt like it was a little too much for a canvas piece. However, I justified it by saying that this is a runway piece. It's not a bag that you see too often. And reverse monogram pieces usually go for a little more than the regular monogram. This is my first reverse monogram piece in my collection, and I absolutely fell in love with the reverse monogram. I have been wanting to add a reverse monogram for so long, and I just never really found the right piece. I absolutely love this chain. I think it's a chain that you won't really see too often. It is very different, but if you are worried about the chain, you're also able to switch out the chains to like a different strap. So for instance, I would be able to use my mini palm springs strap in here and be able to hook it up, and it would match with no problem just because it's black on black. So here is my palm springs mini. Just for reference, if you guys have the palm springs mini and you guys want to get an idea on the sizing, so it is fairly similar. If I turn it like this, you can see that it's fairly similar, only that I feel like this one fits my items a little more comfortably because this has more of a north and south, therefore I would have to stack this a little more, whereas this I'm able to put it side by side. And I also have the Denise BB here if you guys want to see the comparison, just in case you have the BB and you want to get an idea of the size. Here's the front. Here is the side. Obviously, the Denise BB is a lot larger. This one is more comparable with the Denise Mini, and it is a lot more affordable. So the Denise Mini, I believe, is like in the 900s, and this one is, like I said, at like the $2,500. So it is more than double, almost triple, but I didn't want to get the Denise Mini. I just wanted to get this bag as a bag, use it as a bag, and I already had the Denise BB, so I figured I wanted something different. So that is all I have for you guys in this video. I really hope you guys found this video helpful. If you guys have any questions, comments, thoughts, or anything like that, please leave them in the comment section down below. I hope you guys have a great day or night, and I'll see you guys on my next video. Bye guys.